one of the biggest gang busts in the history of the United States. One of them. Did you hear about it? No. Wonder why? Put up his picture full mass here. Federal government told us about it on Friday. His name is Christopher Lamar Baker. Mr. Baker is the leader of a gang called the Pagan Motorcycle Club. That's what the gang is called. It should just be called a gang. All right? Show all of the weapons they found, and they also found a whole lot of meth, many other things. And he was involved in money laundering. I mean, this guy ran the gamut. You didn't hear about it. The Raleigh-based national leader of the Pagans Motorcycle Club. Once again, it's a gang, not a motorcycle club, a gang. Recognized by law enforcement as an outlaw motorcycle gang, will spend the rest of his life behind bars. Christopher Lamar Baker, 49 years of age, was sentenced to 75 years in prison on Friday for a total of 17 charges. Those charges range from drug trafficking and firearm charges to money laundering. During the sentencing announcement, Michael Easley, the United States Attorney for the Eastern District of North Carolina, called Baker a prolific meth trafficker. Court evidence showed Baker supplied over 268 kilograms of meth into Raleigh area and surrounding states in the East Coast. The ATF and Raleigh police showed some of the 46 confiscated firearms. These are not all of them. Along with photos of Pagans Club jackets, drug signs, inciting violence, and showing swastikas. A white supremacist gang. There's more. He's been stripped of his patches, stripped of his colors, stripped of his motorcycle, said Easley, who is the prosecutor. Let me pause on this. Prosecutor. When you say things like this about gang members, when you say he's been stripped of his patches, you give those patches power. I've never heard you say a Crip was stripped of his scarf. The reason you don't say that, Mr. Prosecutor, is you do not believe those bandanas have power. Okay? But when you say patches have been stripped, like somebody has been told to give me your badge. See, that badge actually has power. Those patches do not. When you arrest the cop, do you say he's been stripped of his badge? I got more. He's been stripped of his patches, stripped of his colors, stripped of his motorcycle, said Easley during the press conference. He will never again feel the freedom of the open road that millions of law-abiding bikers feel every day. Easley said Baker is one of 20 defendants in this operation, including a dozen Pagan members and two drug suppliers. Now, you may say, well, goodness, I haven't heard of this story. Why have I missed it? Maybe it was a small operation. Maybe a lot of undercover cops here. One department working with the DOJ. That would make sense. Put it up. Let me show you how many law enforcement agencies were involved, and most of them released their own press release that did not get picked up by many members of media. Assistant U.S. attorneys Kelly L. Sanding and Robert Dotson prosecuted the case. Other agencies involved include North Carolina Highway Patrol, the Virginia State Police, the DeKalb County, Georgia Police, the Borough County Sheriff's Office, Georgia, the Georgia State Patrol, the Gwinnett County Police Department, Georgia, the Cleveland County Sheriff's Office, North Carolina, South Carolina Highway Patrol, the Craven County Sheriff's Department, the Lexington County Sheriff's Department, and the Reedsville Police Department, North Carolina. All of them were involved with the federal government to bring down this major gang. And you barely heard a peep. Guarantee you, if the person in charge would have been a member of the Piru Bloods, you would have heard about it. But ladies and gentlemen, it's not even a motorcycle club. It is a white supremacist gang, is what they are. Their literature, their particular brand of philosophy, as well as their symbols, speak to the nature of their organization. However, you will not find one report that talks about their white supremacist ideology. All right, food for thought. Mr. Mayor, thoughts here?
Listen, this is where we have to be critical of what our national media is saying. First of all, it does not fit the narrative that these drugs are being smuggled by people whose last name is Gonzalez or Ramirez or Richey or Robinson. When you put up the truth of the matter that one of the largest drug busts, we are in the sentencing phase. We're done with the sentencing phase, and we've not heard anything about it. When we hear people in Chicago being arrested for 2 and 3 pieces of crack. This is a discrepancy that the national media has to come and reckon with. The fact that you can exclude and ignore this. And you said something that is extremely powerful that people should not braze over. The idea that when they say he's been stripped of his badges and his patches, you're actually saying that the gang is against this behavior. No, they didn't strip him of his patches. He's gonna go in prison and be secure because of those patches. Those patches won't give him power out here, but inside he'll be protected by that same patch. So implying that those patches don't mean nothing or they were taken from him because he's arrested is a falsehood. It is a big falsehood. And like you said, it gives power and it also gives legitimacy to this gang. To this gang. It's saying that this gang is deterred or bothered by this behavior when in actuality, this is what they are known for. So I think this is an absolute critique, one of the media for sure, but also America public in general and how they see who is responsible for the drug problem in this country.
Very well said, Mr. Mayor.